Okay, in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to find all the cube roots of the number 1. And you might be wondering, isn't that the answer just equal to 1? Yes, if you just want to talk about the real numbers, but not once we are talking about the complex numbers as well. Let me show you how. And I will show you guys two ways to do this. The first way is just going to be algebra, and then the second way is that we will have to use sine, cosine, and also the polar form of a complex number to help us out, okay? So take a look. And by the way, this is also called the cube root of unity. The unity is the number 1, okay? Anyway, here we go. To find the cube root of a number is that I want to have a number x, so that when I raise that to the third power, I will end up with the number I'm looking for, namely 1. So we have to solve this equation. And as I mentioned earlier, 1 is definitely a solution for this, right? Because 1 to the third power is equal to 1. And to find out the other solutions, this is what we can do. That's minus 1 on both sides, so I will have x to the third power on the left, minus 1. But you see, this is going to be a difference of a cube, and I'm going to put 1 as 1 to the third power as well. So I can look at this as a difference of 2 cubes, okay? And then, of course, we have this equal to 0. Now we can factor this out. And to factor this out, the first factor is x minus 1, like this. And then the second one is going to be x, and you square that, so you have x squared, and you add it with this times that, x times 1, just x. And then you add it with 1 squared, it's still 1. So this is what we have. And now, let's just do the usual business. Put this down as equal to 0, so x minus 1 is equal to 0, and then, of course, x is equal to 1. And to find out the complex answers, here is the deal. I will have to make x squared plus x plus 1 equal to 0, and to solve this, let's just use the quadratic formula. And notice that the a, b, c values are all equal to 1. It's really cool, huh? Anyway, so I will just tell you that x is equal to negative b, which is 1, plus minus square root of b squared, which I will write down b squared, 1 squared, right? And then minus 4 times a, which is 1, and c is also 1, so 4 times 1 times 1. And then all over 2 times 1, right? So this is what we have. And now, of course, we can simplify this a little bit. This is negative 1 plus minus square root. This is 1 minus this is 4. 1 minus 4 is negative 3, like this. And then over 2 times 1, which is 2, okay? So in the end, I will just tell you guys, here are these three answers. The first one is the real answer, x is equal to 1. And then I will write down the second answer for you guys this way. I will tell you the second is x equal to negative 1 half. Let's put that down first, because you want to write a complex number in the a plus bi form, right? Usually speaking. Anyway, I will put down plus, and you know you have a negative in the square root, so that's the I, and then you have the square root of 3 over 2, okay? And then x equal to negative 1 over 2, and then we have the minus version, and then we'll have the I, and then the square root of 3 over 2, like that. And you can put the I here, or put the I at the end, right here. It's like up to you, seriously. Okay? But anyway, here are the three answers for you guys. Now, here is the more interesting part. And perhaps it's easier if you have seen the sine, cosine, and also the polar form of a complex number. But, you know, if you haven't seen this, then, you know, you can just pick something up as well. That's really cool as well. Anyway, here is the deal. To find the cube root of 1, we are going to look at, I know we have some complex answers, right? So I will use omega. You can use z as well, okay? Doesn't really matter. Anyway, omega to the third power, we want this to be equal to 1. And in this case, omega is a complex number, and I will write omega as a plus bi, okay? And now, the idea is that when we have a complex number, and once we raise that to a power, it pretty much just rotates, especially if you're talking about the unity like this, okay? So now the idea is that I will be looking at the complex plane right here, okay? So here is the real axis, and this is the imaginary axis. Anyway, omega to a third power is equal to 1. That suggests us to look at the unit circle, right? A circle with radius 1, okay? Anyway, I want to end up with 1. The idea is that I want to have, let me just put down. This is like 1 plus 0i, so we're talking about this point right here, okay? 0, this is 1 plus 0i, okay? And then I want to go from here. You know that's the first solution. I want to go from here. I want to rotate, and then come back here. Okay, that's the deal. Well, the idea is that a circle is 360 degrees. I want to rotate, meaning I do it 3 times. 360 degrees divided by 3 is 120 each time, right? And yes, I'm just going to be using degrees, okay? Anyway, so if you go from here, let me just put this down. Let me just make it dark first. This is starting. And then rotate 120 degrees. You are talking about somewhere here, right? So let me just draw this for you guys. 120 degrees. And guess what? If you can find out the coordinate of this point right here, you have the cube root of 1, okay? You have a solution to this. And then we can do the same again, right? So if you start right here and then rotate 120 degrees like this. In fact, you pretty much just do a reflection about the x-axis. And let me just draw this for you guys down like this. So from here to here is another 120 degrees. And this point is also going to be representing a cube root of 1. And our goal is to figure out the coordinate of this point and that point. This point is really easy. It's just 1 plus 0i. But anyway, to do so, you see that we have the angle already, right? So I'm going to look at this. I will change that into the polar form. And to do that, the x value is pretty much the x value, right? You just associate that with the usual polar coordinates. It's just that we will have r times cosine of whatever the angle that you're talking about. So I'll put down theta for that. And then I will put down the plus. The b is just the y value, so you use sine, and you still have the r. And let me put down the I first, okay? And then we have r sine theta like this. So this is pretty much it. And in our case, r is equal to 1, okay? R is equal to 1. And you can imagine if you have omega to the third power is equal to 8, then in this case, the r will be what? The r will be 2, okay? You can try, yeah, because you want to look at r as the real value to a third power is equal to 8 in that case, so r is equal to 2. But anyway, in our case, this is nice, r is equal to 1, okay? And now you have the answers pretty much. The first answer, I'll just tell you omega is equal to 1. And then the second answer is going to be omega equal to, because r is 1 already, so let me just put on the cosine and also the sine part and the I, of course. First one is cosine of 120 degrees, and yes, I am still using degrees, but hopefully that doesn't bother you. I and r is 1, so we have I times sine, and then theta is once again 120 degrees. And then the last one is going to be omega equals to cosine of 240 degrees, right? Because you have to go from here to here, okay? This is a total of 240 degrees, like that. So 240 degrees right here plus I sine of 240 degrees. And if you want to know more about this, you know, I have some pages for you guys to read over. You can also talk about the De Moivre's theorem for this kind of things, and it's pretty much a rotation. But anyway, I just want to get this done for you guys. First answer, omega equals to 1. Now, cosine of 120, if you want to do some usual trigonometry things, you can look at a reference triangle right here with this angle being 60 degrees, right? And anyway, cosine of 120 degrees is going to be negative 1/2. So the second is going to be right here. We have negative 1/2 plus sine of 120 degrees. It's going to be square root of 3 over 2. So I will put down square root of 3 over 2 with the I in front, just like that. And now for this one, omega will be cosine of 240. They have the same x value, so we still have negative 1/2. But this time, sine of 240 degrees, we will have the negative value of this y value, so it's become minus. Minus I square root of 3 over 2, like this. And with this, we are done. Okay? And in fact, I'm going to use this in one of my videos later on, so that's why I'm doing this. But hopefully you guys also find that this is pretty cool. And leave a comment down below and let me know which method do you guys like better.